What's up, everybody? I'm about to come at you with a brand spanking new convenience store tour. But before I do, I just want to let you know about this month's Japanese Happy Halloween Snack Pack. If you sign up for the snack service this month, you'll get a mighty fine selection of Japanese Halloween snacks in that box. So feel free to check out my link down below in the description box for more info, and now it's time for your regularly scheduled program. What's up, everybody? It's time for another convenience store tour in Tokyo, Japan. So I was scampering around the mean streets of downtown Tokyo, came across a Lawson, and decided to give it a go. I basically felt like I needed a large quantity of empty calories in my life pronto, so I started checking out the savory snacks zone. And whoa boy, take a look at this snack. We got a nori seaweed ramen snack, and that guy seems crazed out of his mind. And what's this? Seems like we got a bag of potato chips over here, and it says G-Friend on the front, and whoa boy. We got what appears to be Japanese idols on the top of this bag, and on the bottom, we got barbecued meat and garlic. Now, I don't know what the connection is between Japanese idols, G-Friend, and meat, but what I do know is shit is getting crazy up in this mother. I feel like that bag was using those girls' pictures as a crutch, so I want to get some chips that are good on their own merit, and what do we got here? We got some murasaki emo chips, which is basically a Japanese purple sweet potato. Now, I'm not sure if I should buy this bag, but I can't help but notice those red maple leaves on the top. That pretty much means this is a rare fall-only item, so I figured I might as well toss that bad boy into my cart. So now it's time to check out the senbei zone, aka the rice cracker zone, and what in the wide, wide world of sports is this? We got curry senbeis over here, complete with what appears to be an Indian man wearing a turban. That's moderately intriguing, and what's this? We got some Korean cheese takgalbi senbeis, and we got us some strong, spicy barbecue chicken wing senbeis as well. I mean, the concept of having a barbecue chicken rice cracker is exciting enough, but take a look at that guy. There's basically a guy in a fucking chicken suit right there, and we got some kardai as fuck barbecue sauce. Suffice to say, you best believe I tossed that puppy into my cart. And now it's time to check out the chocolate snack zone. And lo and behold, what do we got here? We got us some galbos. These crunchy chocolate snacks never fail to impress, and this particular bag is flavored after sweet potato. I actually do want to try them, but on the same token, I kind of want to try a new snack for a change. Can you actually blame me, baby cakes? And here we got some more sweet potato chocolates, complete with maple leaf on top. And truth be told, I almost want to buy this item, but something's telling me that I shouldn't. Call the snacker's instinct, call it a sixth sense. Call it a blood sugar spiker's intuition, but I just so happen to think that I should get myself these murasaki emo chocolate sticks. Maybe it's because I never actually had a murasaki emo in real life, but I feel like these snacks are filling a hole in my motherfucking soul. I was getting pretty excited to try out those sticks, so I slam dunked them into my cart. And what other kind of snacks do we got around here? Murasaki emo chocolate mushrooms? There's a lot of fucking murasaki emo snacks around here. Almost too many. And what in the world is this? Holy jeez, this can't be what I think it is. I think it just so happens to be chocolate-covered edamame beans. That's some crazy-ass motherfucking buck-wild shit, so I decided I might as well toss that puppy into my cart. Then I made my purchase and sprinted on back to my apartment. Then I sat myself down with a sense of pride, and I sat myself down with a sense of a purpose. I grabbed those murasaki emo chips and got mentally prepared to snack my way to a higher state of consciousness. So I whipped out my handy dandy travel scissors and gave that bag a generous snip. I mean, sure, I could have opened that bag the old-fashioned way. I just kind of wanted to keep things classy over here. It's kind of taking too long, though, so let's just finish it off with my hands and whoa, boy, whoa, whoa. I started pulling open that tab and the damn thing exploded all over the place. I guess my travel scissor strategy kind of backfired. I got murasaki emo chips flying left and right over here. Nevertheless, I'm keeping this shit P.I. till I D.I., so I got those murasaki emo chips on deck. And as you can see, those perfectly puffed puppies are looking purple to the motherfucking max. Definitely some of the better murasaki emo chips I've seen lately, that's for damn sure. But at any rate, these chippy whippies ain't gonna eat themselves, so after carefully inspecting that bad boy, I took myself a bite. And whoa boy, didn't get much flavor in that bite, so maybe I need to get myself a nice little stack. Call me crazy, but I just feel like chips don't quite taste as good unless you got a nice little stack jammed inside your mouth, but hey, what do I know? So I bit down on that chip stack, and this time I did get some flavor in that bite. These chips have a buttery flavor with some kind of unidentifiable starch flavor to them. The starch flavor is like a cross between a sweet potato and a normal potato, with an ever so slight, subtle grape aftertaste. And overall, it's pretty decent, but if I had to rate it, I think I'd have to give this snack a 3 out of 5 dogs. I mean, I don't actually know how a murasaki emo is supposed to taste, but I do like the flavor of this snack. The only problem I have is the flavor just isn't quite strong enough. I mean, I feel like I'm eating air over here, people. Nevertheless, that's a pretty nice fucking snack. So now it's time to move on to the strong, spicy chicken wing rice crackers. Basically any snack that has a guy in a freaking chicken suit seems like a nice snack in my book, and I have a mighty good feeling about these rice crackers. So let's skip the scissors this time and go for that pull tab action, and whoa boy, that was smooth as butter. That was one state-of-the-art aerodynamic space-age pull tab if you ask me. So after successfully opening that package, I poured out its contents, and wow, just fucking wow. Theoretically, we got some rice crackers here, but if I didn't know any better, I'd say what we got here is some perfectly formed popcorn chicken. So let's take a closer look to see what I'm talking about. I mean, what do you think, baby cakes? It kinda looks like chicken to me, not 100%, but there is a certain resemblance to it all. So I took myself a suave and sophisticated bite, and whoa. The texture of the outside tasted kinda like Korean fried chicken. I mean, the outside is crunchy yet slightly sticky, but the inside? The inside has a weird, soft, slightly foamy texture to it, but then again it is puffed rice, so I guess I can't complain. Now, as far as the flavor is concerned, there's a slight black pepper flavor, along with a sweet and spicy barbecue sauce flavor. The first bite tasted pretty decent, but with each passing bite, I feel like that flavor's actually compounding on itself. It's getting spicier and spicier, yet I can't stop eating them. I feel like I'm getting kind of addicted to these things. In fact, if I had to rate them, I think I'd give them a 4 out of 5 dogs. After all, they started off kind of foamy, but with each passing bite, that flavor was a building and a building. And by the end, my mind started to be convinced that I was eating some real popcorn chicken, but hey, I'm getting a tad off topic. So next up, it's time to move on to the chocolate murasaki emo sticks. After all, I did try out a savory murasaki emo snack, and now I'm trying out a sweet one. Now I'm kinda wondering, is this snack naturally purple because of the murasaki emo content? Or is it purple because they jacked it with a shitload of food coloring? I'm leaning toward the latter. Nevertheless, you do got to admire that purple hue. What shade would you call that purple anyway? Because me personally, I think I'd call it nuclear winter purple. It's got a nice drab radioactive hue popping off. Key takeaway, nice fucking color shade. So after taking a look at those purple sweet potato chocolate sticks, I took myself a magnificent nibble. And whoa boy, I don't know why, but I kind of expected a stick inside that chocolate, but apparently I was wrong. Apparently I was dead wrong. Instead of having a cracker stick inside, it was basically just soft chocolate with some rice puffs in there. Now, as for the flavor, it's kind of similar to those chips I had earlier, minus the butter flavor, but plus more sweetness. Just like those chips, it tastes like a cross between a sweet potato, a normal potato, and it has a slight grape aftertaste. Now, luckily the flavor is a lot stronger than those chips, but still, overall, the snack isn't exactly changing my life. I'm not exactly sure why, but it doesn't really excite me, so I think I'd have to rate it a 3 out of 5 dogs. I mean, don't get me wrong, it is a nice snack, I just don't think it makes it to the upper echelon of snacks, that's the main point I'm trying to get across. So last but not least, it's time for our fourth and final snack, a little thing I like to call the white chocolate coated edamame. I don't know what to expect from this snack. I feel like it's either gonna be the best damn snack I ever had in my life, or it's gonna be weird as hell. I mean, whoever came up with the idea of chocolate-covered soybeans? Anyway, I got that pull tab off, but it seems like this Ziploc is damn near welded shut. They're making me work hard for these soybeans. In fact, they're making me work real fucking hard. Anyway, eventually that bag did cooperate and open for me, so I poured out the contents and whoa. They just look like some unassuming white orbs. You can't even tell that there's an edamame inside, but oh, I trust them, baby. It's kind of weird to think about, though. I mean, I've had chocolate-covered raisins, chocolate-covered peanuts, and even chocolate-covered macadamia nuts. But a chocolate-covered soybean? Shit is getting crazy over here, sweetie buns. So let me bite this thing in half and see what it really looks on the inside. And wow, basically looks like a dehydrated soybean. It's got a simple beany flavor, a sort of crunchiness, and a sweet white chocolate flavor. I'm not quite sure if I'm disappointed or impressed. I mean, I do generally like chocolate-covered food items, but this one in particular is kinda weird. Just imagine a dehydrated wasabi pea, but instead of having a wasabi flavor, it's just covered with chocolate. It's not exactly bad, but at the same time, it's not exactly good either. So if I had to rate it, I think I'd give it a 3 out of 5 dogs. I mean, the chocolate tasted good, but the soybean tasted weird, although I must say I did enjoy that novelty factor. So after chomping down on those chocolate-covered edamames, this incredible convenience store tour came to a close. Oh, and by the way, if you want to get your very own Japanese snack experience, then you best be checking out my Japanese Halloween snack box. It's absolutely guaranteed to change your life, presumably for the better, and I got that link down below in the description box. Or if you want to check out some more convenience store action, then feel free to check out my previous episode. I got that link down below as well. And as always, thanks for watching this video, everybody. Why don't you leave a comment? Let me know what you think.